Hi, good Saturday, Jubilant Saturday morning, everybody, and welcome to your first Saturday of December, Daily Devo, episode 558, part 1. For Saturday, December the 4th, 2021. Today we're going to be talking about salvation versus assurance of salvation. Beginning with 1 John 2:5. So if you're excited about another Jubilant Saturday, smash that like button. Comment what you like about Saturdays. Comment something that you do on the weekends that maybe other people don't do. Comment one activity that you always do on the weekend that maybe somebody else doesn't do or hasn't ever done. Subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, and share the video and channel with your family and friends and help me reach that goal of 100 subscribers by January the 15th, which will be episode 600. But today is 21 days till Christmas. 3 weeks. 3 weeks. Till Christmas. And that's 28 days till the end of the year. I think so. Four. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. Three weeks tomorrow for Christmas. So that's still 22 days. So 3 weeks tomorrow, but it's 4 weeks today that we have left. 4 exact weeks. 4 exact weeks. Because there's 31 days. Take away 4. That's 28. 4 weeks to the end of the year. And then tomorrow will be 3 weeks till Christmas. So that's 21 days. So I was a little ahead of myself. So, but that gives us 8 plus 5 is 13, carry the 1. 2 and 1 is 3, plus 1 is 4. So you got 43 days. 43 days till 600. So. But without further ado, let's get into it. Today we're going to learn how to judge salvation by itself. An assurance of salvation. Beginning with 1 John 2:5, which states, "But whoso keepeth his word, in him verily is the love of God perfect. Hereby know we that we are in him." That's a difficult phrase to try to say a little bit fast. You have to. So the New Testament is emphatically clear that we are saved entirely by the grace of God through faith in Christ. "For by grace are ye saved through faith. It is the gift of God, lest any man should boast." Ephesians 2:8, and that last part, "I mean any man should boast," verse 9. But how can we know for sure that our professed faith in Christ is genuine and we are really saved? Many who claim to be Christians are not truly saved. Many who claim to be Christians, wait a minute. For Christ said, "Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven." Matthew 7:21. Now, Note that John's main purpose in writing his gospel was to win people to saving faith in Christ. John 20:31. These are written that ye might believe in Jesus, that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing ye might have life through his name. So then the ultimate purpose of his first epistle was to assure them they were saved. 1 John 5:14. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life. Amen? So thus, we not only have salvation, but also assurance of salvation. If we love and guard his word, seek to keep his commandments, and love all others like the precious faith. So finally, we have the indwelling witness of the Spirit. 1 John 3:24 says, hereby we know that he abideth in us by the Spirit which he has given us. Amen? There's a wham-bam thank you ma'am thing today. But coming up in your episode 559 part 1 tomorrow for Sunday, for Lord's Day Sunday, before I go any further, I'm giving you the preview of tomorrow's passage for the morning video. But starting tomorrow through next Sunday, every morning video, I will put on another playlist by itself, but also go on the Daily Devo. This will not be part of the Duh series. These next 8 days, these are not, I had done these next 8 devotions. I don't know whether they're the same or they revamped them a little bit. But go back in my miscellaneous Devo playlist and look for the title, The 8 P's of a Christian. P apostrophe S. I don't know whether I did it all in one video or did I split them up? 1, 2, or 2, 3. I know at least, if I split them up, it was at least 2, if not more. But I called it the 8 P's of a Christian. And this just happens to be the same ones that I did back in one of those random Devos I did on like a Wednesday or a Friday. I just added an extra one to the day because I didn't have, at that time, I only had the days of praise. So I was adding an evening video for like a bonus video. But now that I have these two here and then the turning point, it's hard to do things like that. But I can do it like on Saturdays because I only have the days of praise and the daily bread. But starting at that, it's the 8 P's of a Christian. Number 1. And we're going to be talking about it tomorrow. We're going to start with the Christian's position. P. Position. And then Monday, we'll be talking about the Christian's purpose. I'll just give you the first two. But each day, there's a P word. The Christian's blank. So I would love for you to, each day, write the titles down and bulleted them so you will understand them. And go back, I will try to, in each one of those videos, I'm just going to record this video and then the next video, and I want to try to do some of those together in one sitting. I might record Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, and then come back and record our Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, record those 3 days. The next day, come back and record Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And then the next day, record Saturday and Sunday. But just record. And as I go each day I'm recording, I'll get the other one, the daily bread and the turning points, I'll get them. I'll try to get Sundays done, and then go back and do Mondays and Tuesday. I'd like to get them all recorded in one city, and then go back later and record the other videos. But sorry for rambling about this. I just realized, but we'll be getting into the 8 P's of Christian. So basically, what I'll do right now is do like I had planned. Do today's and then do tomorrow's while I'm sitting here. So I get them up, get them loaded, get them ready to go when it comes time for me to edit them and post them, which is usually during the evening. I'll get them posted for the next day. So, but it is what it is. Coming up in your part two for today, we're going to be talking about Generation Now, episode 558, part two. This one comes from Tim Gustafson again. And this one is derived from 2 Kings 20, verses 1 through 19. And you get the numbers 1 through 19. And then you look over here, there's 20. But I like when numbers do that sometimes. But that's what's coming up next. That's what's coming up in the next video today. So stay tuned. I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Sorry for the long rambling at the end. I realized what was coming up for tomorrow morning video in the next 8 days. What's gonna happen? So it's gonna be like a little mini series, but it's gonna be the regular videos. So we'll just take them as it goes. So. I've basically already done it, so I don't have to worry about doing it all in one sitting, so I would understand it more in one sitting. Let's just go along with everything, and we'll be all right. But keep on keeping on and trusting God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Jubilant Saturday morning, and come back again later this evening at 5 o'clock, because there will be no turning point today. So the video will be after 5 instead of 1. And then on Sunday, it'll be after 1, because we got the weekend series video for turning point. So stay tuned, and I'll see y'all later. I'll see y'all this evening.